The guys and I met freshman year of high school in religion class.
We went to an all-boys high school, and the only way to meet girls was to do the improv class and the plays.
Wanted to make people laugh. The improv club was the perfect way to do that.
We all did improv together in high school. We all went to separate colleges, and we all were doing it on our own.
We graduated college, and I was on the ferry one day commuting to work, and I ran into Sal. And we were reminiscing about doing improv together and how much fun it was.
And we came back together after college and formed the Tenderloins comedy troupe.
The guys and I rehearsed in Joe's mother's basement for 6 years.
We just were having so much fun doing it for nobody. We're like, let's try doing it for somebody and see how it works.
We all had day jobs, and we did improv and sketch comedy live on stage for like 5 or 6 years.
Go back one step further, and you take out if Mike Boccio, who was the original Tenderloin, didn't decide to get married and get a good job and say, okay, I'm not going to try this anymore.
He wouldn't have been empty
for Q to come in and really take it to the next level.
The four of us did improv in high school together, and then used to guest perform with us from time to time.
Yeah.
If Mike hadn't
there's another job
and had a kid, it would have gone.
But we still talk to. We're friends with.
Would have gone a different way, and I do credit you for a lot of the success that we've had, because the three of us at the end of the day, I think, have a very similar kind of silly, slapsticky kind of sense of humor. And when Q came on board full time, he brought an edge to us and our comedy that we didn't have before. You know, it just sharpened, and the writing got better, the sketches had an edge to them they didn't have before.
It's the right ingredient. You needed a splash of Q.
You needed a splash of some dark, depressing stuff sprinkled in.
I think it was too optimistic.
Before we even got an edge, then we got one, we had like 4 or 5 shows that didn't go, and we just luckily found the right thing at the right time.
We were ready to kind of close up shop and call it a day. We were just like, maybe it's just not gonna happen.
Then the offer came in for our series.
We got the TV show.
It took a long time to get a TV show.
We always say we're a 19-year overnight success.